Okay. It's got the wrong camera. Oops, let's go there.
We don't want to look at the
There we
show.
Go. It's nice. Going live. Hey, everybody.
Hello.
It's Brad and Christa, and today we're doing something very special indeed. The first time we've tried this, but Mama is going to be making...
Wait. Not the first time we've tried this bread.
No.
The first time we've tried making it live.
Yeah. So if we mess up, you're going to know.
Yeah.
And what we've done, guys, is we've tried to give you the heads up that if you want to actually bake it with us, we put the recipe out there, but we're going to go over it again so that if you want to jump in, you can jump in. Because what we're doing is we actually have three different stages.
Yes.
We've got the beginning stage, and then we've got a pre-risen stage, and then one that's ready to go.
Right. That way we're not you guys are not having to wait a half an hour for the bread to rise and then another half an hour for the bread to bake.
Right.
Kind of silly.
So we're going to basically show you these phases. Mm-hmm. Mama's going to show you how to roll it into breadliness. That's really a term.
Well, that one actually I should have rolled already. Mistake number one.
But we'll show you what we got.
Right.
So, first of all, let's talk about what you got out there, Mama. And you got a very lovely apron. Here, let me grab this.
I forgot about my apron.
Let's come on over here.
She's in her apron.
She is in her apron.
Yes.
Cleanliness is next to breadliness. So, what do we got? I'll go over the recipe while you're getting yourself strapped in.
That's nice.
So, it's also in the description, guys, but we've got 2.5 cups of warm water. That's going to be between 80 and 90 degrees.
Mm-mm.
No?
No, about 105.
105.
Just where it's just barely too hot to touch.
Okay. We've got 4 teaspoons of sugar, 1 tablespoon of dry active yeast, 4 to 5 cups of flour. You can use whatever flour you like. We use bread flour for everything.
Pretty much.
4 teaspoons of salt. And we're going to bake it at 375 for 30 minutes. Show us your hardware, baby.
All right. We have our sugar, our flour, measuring cup, our yeast, and our salt. And I'm going to use the KitchenAid, and I can show you how I knead it. But this, I got to tell you, is way easier. Takes less time. Your dough is ready and nice and smooth in about a minute.
Okay.
So.
And you prefer to do the baking on a cookie sheet with parchment paper.
Yes, I do. And because, well, the cookie sheet, it's kind of gross. So I use parchment paper so that the bread does not stick.
Okay. So for those of you who are going to try to follow along, we have this in 3 stages, as I said earlier. And we do have some options over here. Right. These are not optional for us. We love to make sure that we have a nice egg wash, and then you stick your seeds on there. We definitely like the sesame seeds. You could put any combination of anything you like on there. But what we have over here is one of the batches that's already been risen, and another so that you guys don't have to wait around so much on us. And there's Claire. She's on troll patrol.
Yep.
So I don't know where Mama went.
I forgot. My dough knife.
Oh, one other thing too. The olive oil.
The olive oil is just for the bowl so that your dough does not stick.
And we'll talk about all this as we're going.
Yep.
So I think, are we ready to begin?
Are we? Well, we probably should roll out those.
Okay, we'll go ahead and roll the one
and
out.
And we will roll them again, but I got to get those rolling so that, or rolled.
So that it has time to rise.
So it has time to rise so we can put it in the oven.
So this is not an official start, but Mama's going to show you how to roll this out because we forgot to do it earlier.
Sorry.
So.
All right.
Oop. Now this is dough that has already risen.
For a half an hour or more.
About a half an hour.
Yeah, about 45 minutes, but generally it takes about half hour.
And we are going to go over this again. This is just because of our boo-boo.
Yeah. Now, you take it out of the bowl, and you're not going to mess with it at all. You're not going to knead it. You're not going to knock it down. What you're first going to do is just sprinkle a little flour.
So there's no stickiness.
So there's no stickiness. And then...
We're in a little tight area here.
Yeah. And then you roll it out.
And what are you looking for?
A rectangle. I need a rectangle shape. I got a little space.
That is one delightful looking stick thing you have there.
This is a friend of the channel sent us a French rolling pin, which was oh so very kind.
Hey, Jan Rohr. We are doing well. We hope you're doing well as well. Yeah. As well as well. And so you're looking for generally a rectangular shape.
Just a rectangle. Doesn't have to be exact. Doesn't even have to be perfect.
Well, if perfect was the case, I'd never get it done.
Yeah. Me neither.
Yeah.
I don't have enough room here.
Yeah, by the way, we don't normally cook in the schoolroom, as you can see. However, Claire needs to be here on Troll Patrol. And we needed to be close to the Wi-Fi to make this work.
Yep. Okay, so we have, well, an oval, but this will make our dough shape right. So now what you're going to do is you're going to divide it in half. If you don't have one of these dough knives, just use a regular knife.
Why are we taking over the schoolroom? Well, that's because we needed to... This is the best place to do the video.
Yeah.
Normally, we would be in the kitchen.
But we have an island to work from.
Yeah.
So, now, we're going to roll this into a log. So, you're going to start with the short end and just tuck it in. And just give it, just roll it up. Now, for the ends, you just curl it under like so. Make sure your seam is on the bottom. Okay, it's kind of hard to show backwards.
There we go.
Here. So we made a nice snake.
A snake.
Now.
A bread snake.
Yeah. Put that here.
And that's gonna rise.
And this will be allowed to rise. Here, I'll show you again.
There we go.
Okay. And this
bread.
Bread dough we use?
Yes. We use bread dough, but you can use all purpose if you like.
Bread flour.
Bread flour, dough. Sorry.
Okay.
Oh, can this dough be used for anything else? Lots of things.
We use this for pizza crusts. We use this for regular sandwich bread. If you wanted to make it into sandwich bread, you would just flatten it out and then roll it into a shorter log, and then put it in your loaf pan.
Okay, so now this is ready to just be...
I cover this with a warm, wet towel, okay, and let it rise for a half an hour.
All right, so let's... pass this to Jonathan. Are you going to grab that?
Jonathan, cover this with a warm... the red towels that are down there.
Oh, she's gone. I guess I'll do a little tap dancing.
Sorry. Okay. I'm back.
Okay, so now we're actually going to start from scratch. That was just because we forgot to do that. And I'm going to put the camera in the tripod here. Yep. There we go.
I think I need a hair thing. Can I have a brown one? Will this be soft or crusty? It will be soft and a little bit crusty on the outside. It'll have a nice crisp, but crumb. Soft... crust.
Okay, so it'll be a little of both.
Yeah, but it'll be nice and chewy, nice and soft in the middle.
Alright, so first things first. Now, you guys have all had plenty of time to grab your ingredients if you're cooking along with us.
Okay. I warmed up some water on the stove in my tea kettle, just because it's easier. I need 2.5 cups of warm water.
So this, we're actually starting the recipe now, guys.
Mm-hmm. And see, I can put my finger in that. It's warm.
But it's not going to make you recoil.
Hot. Right, it's not going to be like, oh my gosh, my finger is burning off.
There's two.
And then just a half.
There you go.
Okay. Now, into this warm water, I forgot my tablespoon.
I'll go get it.
It's hanging on the wall.
Gotcha.
I'm always forgetting something. Sorry, guys. Is there a question?
I think so.
Okay.
I need to find it again.
Okay.
Do you have any experience with gluten-free bread?
I do not. Sorry.
Jonathan can't find the bread towels. Claire knows where they are.
Claire knows where
they are. Claire to the rescue. Way to go, Claire.
We, thankfully...
Wait, hold on. Yeah, you gotta tell me what you're doing.
No, I know. But somebody asked a question about gluten-free flour.
Oh.
None of our kids or us have any gluten allergies. So I do not... Sorry, I don't have
We don't know about that.
No.
So now you've got...
So now I'm going to get the 4 tablespoons of sugar.
Teaspoons.
Yes, teaspoons.
Teaspoons.
It's just because I use a tablespoon.
Okay. I'm like, what are you doing?
I use a tablespoon because I know that 1 tablespoon has 3 teaspoons in it. So.
Everybody's going to be confused. They're going to put 4 of these in there.
No. Don't put 4 tablespoons. You'll have really sweet bread.
It would work, but it'd be very sweet.
Yeah, would not be... All right, so now I'm stirring this up to dissolve the sugar.
Uh-huh.
And then I'm going to add the yeast, and that is 3 teaspoons, but I have a tablespoon in here, so there's 3 teaspoons in 1 tablespoon. So I'm adding 1 tablespoon, which actually, I put 1 tablespoon on there.
Okay, and that's dry active yeast.
Yes. And I,
now here, let me show what's going on.
I stored this in the freezer. So this is a nice sealed can I keep in the refrigerator. Now, I sprinkled that yeast in there and I don't touch it. I don't stir it, I don't do anything with it, I just leave it. As you can see, if you can see up close, it's already starting to activate.
Proof.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Okay.
Now what?
Well.
You'll wait.
I don't. A lot of people say you have to wait 5 to 10 minutes till this is nice and bubbly.
Frothy.
And I never have.
Foamy.
I never have. I go ahead and I start by adding the flour. I don't add the sugar yet because you don't want to kill that yeast.
Salt. You've already added your sugar.
Yes.
Say that again.
I don't add the salt yet. I wait until I add the flour, then I add the salt because I don't want to kill the yeast. Okay. So there's 1. And I'll start with 4 because you don't want to over add flour. 3. Because you never know how much you're going to need. On a dry day, you'll need less flour. On a wet day, you'll need more. So now I've got my flour in there. I'm going to add my salt. And it's 4 teaspoons, but I'm using my tablespoon.
You can use regular salt if you like. We prefer the sea salt. Mm-hmm.
And if you guys don't want a lot of sodium in your bread, you can add less salt.
Yeah, absolutely. This is totally a taste thing with the salt.
Yes.
That's the only reason why it's there, is to add flavor. So if you don't like salt at all, don't put any.
Right. Now, you can see that this is pretty dry. Kind of. It's kind of a little bit sticky, but... I'm going to leave it as it is right now, and then I'm going to put it in the mixer, and you'll see it what it looks like when it's done mixing, and we might have to add more flour, we might not.
Dolphin Man has a question.
Yes.
Okay. He just has a small hand mixer. Will that work?
I don't think so.
Well, actually, some hand mixers come with...
A dough hook?
A dough hook, or 2 dough hooks, and I think we have some in the drawer. And they kind of look like this, but they're shorter, and that would work.
So if you've got dough hooks, then it will work. If not, you're gonna have to use your hands.
Right, and you know what? Here, I'll show how I do that real quick. So I add some flour to the counter. Maybe, if I can get it out of there. Okay, just a little bit. And I fold it over and just keep folding.
And you're twisting it around as you're pushing forward.
Right. I give it a quarter to a half turn and fold it. Quarter turn.
So that's how you do it, but we're going to finish it up in the KitchenAid.
Right. If you were going to do this without a mixer, you would do this for about 5 minutes.
Yep. But this is wonderful.
Way faster. and it makes a really nice smooth dough.
And I'm going to try and talk over this a little bit, but how long do you need for this to go?
Well, not long. Now, look here. You see how it has stuck to the sides of the bowl?
It's too wet.
It's too wet. It needs more flour. So I'm going to sprinkle a half a cup of flour in here.
You don't want to overdo it.
No, no. No one overdo it. Add a little bit of flour at a time. Is there a question, hon?
Do we have a recipe for raisin bread?
No.
I do not. Okay, so I'm going to turn this on slow so the flour doesn't poof. Hit me in the face.
Poof.
And once that flour gets incorporated, then I'll turn it up higher.
What are you looking for here?
Not the flour to hit the phone.
Spilled out.
I'm looking for the flour or the dough to pull away from the sides of the bowl.
Pull away from the sides of the bowl, okay.
Yeah. So see how it's kind of pulling together?
Yep.
Okay. I'm going to turn this up higher.
Oh, I see. It's making it into a nice ball.
Yep. See, now, but look at it. As that flour incorporated, look what happened.
It's sticking again.
Sticking again.
Need a little bit more.
Yep. So I'm going to add another half cup. And that's what I had to do with the last batch is I had to add 5 cups of flour.
That's why you start with the 4.
Right, but everybody's environment is different.
What is the difference between French bread and Italian bread?
Italian bread rises longer. You knock it down more. It has...
It's a little more fluffy inside.
Yeah, it has, and it has a really crunchy crust.
Yep. There we go, it's starting to pull away. Okay, looks like you might have got it.
Yep. All right, so I let this go for just a minute.
It's funny,
not even a minute, about 30
look at
seconds.
Our table.
Yeah.
Our table looks like it's possessed.
Yeah.
It's shaking all around.
See how it pulled most of that dough to itself?
Yep.
Now we're good. We're done.
Okay. My wife has one of those KitchenAids. I've never seen her use it for anything other than mashed potatoes.
She needs a new hobby.
Yeah, this recipe that we're showing you guys is great for pizza.
Great for pizza, sandwich bread. Oh, yep. It is so good for sandwich bread.
Oh, and is this the... No, we use the sweet roll recipe for
cinnamon rolls.
Cinnamon
yeah.
buns, yeah.
Okay, so now I'm going to put this out on this floured counter real quick because I want to oil the bowl. Oh, come on. Now, you can see that it is a nice... Whoops. Look at that. That just looks so nice.
Have you ever put nuts or other things in your bread?
No. On occasion. On occasion, you'll branch out. It's usually like the wheat recipes that mm-hmm. she force feeds us.
He hates them.
It's because we don't have a nice fluffy wheat bread recipe yet.
Well, yeah.
And so
okay.
It's experimental.
Dough into the oiled bowl.
You just oiled the bowl.
I just oiled the bowl and covered the... dough so that it does not dry out. And then I'm going to put plastic over the top of this and
it's going to rise for how long?
30 minutes.
30 minutes.
Rise for 30 minutes and then we'll get to the next
step. Okay. But we already have that step ready to go.
So that you guys don't have to wait.
Right. I'll put this in the tripod for a sec. Just for a sec.
Okay.
Now what?
Gotta
move some stuff out of the way.
Move some stuff out of the way.
Yep.
So we don't need this anymore.
That's probably out of the way there.
Yeah.
How often do you bake homemade bread?
Several times a week.
Yes, yes. And sometimes Claire bakes it if I run out of time, but it's generally several times a week. All right, I need some flour.
And our next door neighbors don't know it yet, but they're getting fresh bread because yes. we had to make three recipes instead of just yes. the normal one batch.
Right. Now, normally, we double this recipe, and it will make 3 2-pound sandwich loaves. And they're heavy, but they are...
They're big.
They're big. They're
a pound and a half.
They're 2 pounds.
2 pounders?
Mm-hmm. They're about 2 pounds. So, okay.
You could use them in siege weapons to take out castles.
Yeah. Can you check the other bread, see yep. how big it is? Okay. Any questions, honey?
No, we're talking about mashed potatoes.
Mashed potatoes. I love mashed potatoes.
Does the house smell like bread when it's done?
Oh my gosh. It's ridiculously yummy.
Little Shepherd said, I'll be over shortly for dinner.
Okay, sounds good.
Have you made homemade soft pretzels, aka Philly soft pretzels?
We have attempted to make pretzels. I'm not very good at, I can get the dough right. It's the shaping of it that I can't get down right. And then it's just not right. They're just not right.
Can you freeze it?
This?
Yeah.
The dough.
I'll ask.
Okay. Yeah. I've never frozen the dough. You probably could freeze. You can freeze the bread. I've just never frozen the dough, just because we use so much of it.
For the holidays, I add cream cheese and sour cream, probably.
Yum.
It's not ready yet.
Okay. All right. Well, let's go ahead and put this out on the counter.
Here, we'll get some close-up action of this.
Okay.
We'll grab the camera. Now, this loaf has been, in theory, sitting and rising for how long?
About 45 minutes.
About 45 minutes. So that's when you're going to roll this yeah. out.
Well, you can wait. Usually I wait a half an hour.
Okay.
But with the time difference, it's been 45 minutes. So this is usually half an hour. Okay.
Okay.
Sprinkle this with flour so my pin doesn't stick.
Urban Prepper 1 says, tell your mom I will be on a plane over from the UK for my dinner tonight.
Okay, sounds good.
Hey, bring me a Manchester United jersey.
Yeah.
And Lala Grandbaby says, you bring the mashed potatoes, I will bring the meatloaf.
Awesome. Who's got dessert?
Yeah. No, Prepper 1 needs to bring, not Prepper 1, who is it?
Urban
Prepper 1 needs to bring some shortbread.
Oh yeah, I love me some shortbread. Mm-hmm.
Brad's shirt looked like an optical illusion.
That's funny. Sometimes Brad is an optical illusion.
Somebody asked, do you use a Pullman pan to bake your sandwich bread in?
Nope. I use a regular loaf pan. The ones that you make meatloaf in.
Dolphin Man's asking, how about preheating that oven? And I actually meant to do that and forgot, so I'm going to put this in the tripod and go do it now.
I thought you did.
I thought I did. See? See what happens when you're going live, guys? Hey, mistakes happen.
I'm not the only one making mistakes.
It's 375, right?
375. It does not take long to heat up here, though. That new oven doesn't take long.
Darlene okay, says, I yeah. have fresh, hot cross buns I made earlier.
Yum!
And Brad Talby says, wife says we'll be there in a couple hours.
Hey, you guys aren't far. Come on over.
Yeah. Everybody's saying, oh, I'll come. I'll bring this.
Sweet. So, okay, so this has now a better rectangle than the first
Here,
one
I'll
we
grab
did.
It. I'll grab it. This is more what you're looking for.
That way you have a more even shape. The other ones are probably going to be a little bit more rounded on the top. Now, divide this in half. And you can roll this way. You can roll this way. It does not matter. I always just roll this way. Because then it's a nice long loaf.
Barbara's asking, do you need a pizza stone to bake?
Nope.
You can use a pizza stone, but you do not need a pizza stone.
Nope. You can use a regular cookie sheet with parchment paper, which is what we do. Jonathan.
Someone's saying.
Need another cookie sheet.
Someone's saying, what beautiful dough. And you know what's so cool about this, guys, is that you saw what ingredients went in. There is nothing artificial. There's nothing nasty.
Five ingredients.
Knowing what's in your food is so, so important. Right. No chemicals, no blah, 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 blah.
You know, and also, if you have, if anybody can't have sugar, you can use honey. Thank you, sweetie. Or any kind of sweetener you want. It's, we just use sugar because it's...
You need the sugar, though, to make the bread rise.
Right.
Or else it won't rise properly.
Right.
Okay. What? Yeah, somebody's being a dork. We got a troll.
Got it.
Lovely. Grow up, people.
Yep.
Okay. Now, roll from the ends. Just kind of tuck it in. You know, it's... Bread is a wonderful thing, and it's most of the time very forgiving. Because it doesn't have to look pretty when you get it rolled out, because it's going to rise and it's going to look gorgeous.
Yep.
So you roll this up, and you make sure that the seam is on the bottom. That was why I was moving this one, because the seam got to the side. Okay. Curl it under.
Don't forget to add the sesame and oil like last time.
Yeah.
Oh, this one. Have you tried these with fresh ground flour?
We have.
Yeah, we have. It's
our grinder doesn't get it as nice and fine as this flour here.
Right.
So it does work and it makes bread. It's just a lot less yumminess.
Yeah.
The yumminess factor is like a 3, where this is like a 10.
Right.
Where do you go to get your math that you rolled out?
I found this at Goodwill.
And somebody said you don't pinch the seams closed?
No, I do not. Because they will sit and I roll it under and it will mesh together, I guess you could say.
Yep.
And that's why the seam is on the bottom, because as it rises it will become one. So.
Yep.
So there's that.
So now are you going to add the... Do you add
not
the...
Not to this one. To the other one.
Okay. So now we just need to see if that other one is risen enough. And if it's not, we'll do Q&A for a little bit.
Right.
So I'm going to put this back in the tripod. We're going to go say hi to Claire.
Hi.
Hi, Claire. You know what we'll do while we're stalling? I'll take you on a little tour. Here's books. We've got books. We homeschool. There's the recipe again. Encyclopedias. And if you guys don't have hard copies of books that are important, you need to get hard copies. If you don't know what I'm talking about, watch our channel. And here's all of our beautiful soap that is curing. Look at that. We make this handmade goat's milk soap. And it's ready for sale, actually. We sell that soap. And it's actually, for those of you who might want to, you know, get some soap, it's at bigfamilyhomesteadstore.com. And look at all our lovely, lovely seedlings. We got to thin these guys out, but we got tons and tons of our tomatoes, and all of our stuff is getting ready to go. But let me see, what do you think, Mama?
Yeah, we're gonna go ahead and, because remember, I have the recipe, so these aren't gonna be as big as they normally are.
Okay. How can we buy that soap? You can go to bigfamilyhomesteadstore.com and buy it, and that would be awesome. Now,
let me clear up this flour here.
I'll show them this so far. Now, what Mama was just saying, I don't know if you heard her in the other room, but this recipe was halved.
Yes, for us, as our family, it was in half.
For you guys, if you're making one recipe, like we just showed you, you'd made one loaf. That way it'd be nice and big and fat. Instead of the two loaves, these are kind of going to be more like, I guess, French baguettes. Mm-hmm.
Okay. This.
And for the next part, you're going to need a sharp knife, like this one here. And you're also going to need your egg wash, sesame seeds.
And a pastry brush.
And a pastry brush. Mm-hmm. And the egg wash. How much water to egg?
Just a teaspoon. It's very little. I don't even know why they bother putting the water in there, but...
It does something.
It does something to it.
The viscosity is different. So let me get the camera while they can see up close what you're doing.
Okay.
Okay, so next step is?
The egg wash.
Egg wash?
Mm-hmm. Just lightly brush that on there.
And this helps with the crust, and it also helps glue those sesame seeds on there.
Yep. Is there a question, Claire?
Bandanagram and a couple of people are saying put the camera on the recipe a bit longer.
Okay.
Sure.
It's in the description, guys. I put it in the description, and I don't usually do that because we want you to watch the movie again. Sneaky, sneaky.
Mm-hmm.
But while she's brushing, I'll go ahead and put it on the recipe for just a little bit here.
Elizabeth asks, can she cut down the sugar?
Yes.
You can.
But just don't, you have to maybe try a teaspoon because you want that.
You have to have some sugar or else the yeast won't work right.
The yeast needs to activate and the sugar, it helps, the sugar helps the yeast to activate by eating the sugars.
Okay, so now you got that doused all down there. On go the sesame seeds.
Mm-hmm. Just to not waste too many.
There we go.
Okay.
Now, well, this is ready to go.
Not yet.
Not yet.
One more thing.
Oh, you gotta look at her. She's angry. She's got a knife.
No, it needs, no. Okay, now give your bread just a few slices across the top so that it doesn't burst.
Yeah, when it goes to, when it starts to expand. Mm-hmm.
And it's great decoration. Look at that.
It looks really nice. Look at that. And a sharp knife is really, really important. And also you can wet it down.
Mm-hmm.
That way it'll cut through so it doesn't just drag the dough across.
Right, but our knife is pretty sharp. We just sharpened it not
okay.
too long ago.
I just heard that the oven is ready to go.
Yep, so this is going
so I'm going to follow you.
In the oven.
Here we go.
Here, on the bread.
Here we go. We're on the bread. We're on the bread. She's going backwards.
I'm going backwards.
There's Jonathan. He's got his braces off. Show me your braces off, Jonathan. Lice. So here we go. Into the preheated oven at 375 degrees.
For 30 minutes.
So now is the time we're going to go ahead and answer some questions and chat it up with you guys because we got to wait 30 minutes.
Yep. Start.
Start. 30 minutes.
There we go.
Let's go heckle Jonathan. Jonathan. Show us your smile. Come on. All right.
That's funny.
All right. So now it's Q&A time, guys. What's the matter?
Somebody's trying to, like, do I keep it or no?
Don't care. No. Yeah. So, all right. Hey, there's the United States and where you guys are. You guys are over there. Nice. Okay, let me put this back up in here. Now the question, guys, is do we continue to live stream right now for 30 minutes or do we go off and come back on?
That is entirely up to them.
If you have questions, we'll answer them or we should have thought this through a little bit better. Bread takes time to cook.
We did, it just, I should have rolled those first ones and put it in the oven as we were getting ready to get started.
Well, let's ask you guys. Do you want us to try to keep doing something for 30 minutes and then come back?
I'm way ahead of you.
What?
I already typed that.
Or do you want us to just come back in 30 minutes and restream to show you the finished product? What say you?
Oh! Let's break stuff. Should we break stuff?
Yeah, we can break some stuff.
People want us to stay.
All right, okay. We can stay. I'm going to clean up a little bit.
All right, that's what we'll do. We'll clean and, you guys got to come up with questions because we came to bake bread. So I didn't have any content other than this planned. Come on, people. We need some questions.
Lone Star, should I stay or should I go now?
If I stay, there will be trouble. Or if I go, there will be trouble. Yeah, and if I stay, it will be double. Something like that.
Yeah.
So, here's a question for you guys. What would be a recipe that you would like to see next time?
I'm having a hard time with this.
Well, the thing is, this is our first time doing the live bread, and since there's rise times involved, it's a little harder.
Right.
I was thinking about doing like a really nice bolognese spaghetti sauce with our Thrive foods, Life foods.
Yeah.
Because that stuff is super cool. It's freeze dried, and there's like no prep time at all. You literally just grab stuff and throw it in, put it in your water, and it's done. How about this for try this one for size, guys. No more cutting onions. No more chopping onions.
Claire loves chopping onions, honey.
No, I don't.
It's her favorite.
No. What size is our KitchenAid?
This is the big one.
It's the six, the professional. I think it's, is it the six quart?
Yeah, I think it's the six quart,
the professional. It's the professional 600. Here.
Well, and this was such a blessing from God because I'm a musician and produce, you know, music and all that kind of stuff. And I had a bass guitar that I put up. Somebody saying they wanted a bass. And so I traded them a bass for this, and Mama got a lovely present.
Well, it wasn't just me, it was us.
And
Claire.
It was
for me. It was for Claire.
It's for me.
Cinnamon rolls next time, that's what they're saying. How would we do that?
Bandanagram was asking, do you spray the oven with water to help with crispy crust?
Nope.
Nope, but you can.
Yes, you can.
And the way that we've done that in the past, if you want a crunchy crust.
Use a old metal pan, like an old loaf pan or an old cake pan that you don't like to use anymore, and you keep that in the pan. Keep it in the oven while your oven is heating up. When you go to put your bread in the oven, pour hot water into that pan and make sure it's metal.
And it only has to be a little bit.
Right.
Like a cup of water.
Yeah, a cup of water, because you don't want too much steam.
Yeah, the steam is going to be... What are you doing there, sister?
I turned it on by accident.
She's getting all sassy over here.
I was cleaning it.
If you made... The question...
You need to model the questions like Vanna White, Claire.
No, I will not do that.
Just put your hand up.
Fabulous
prizes.
The recipe is for one sandwich bread if I put it in a loaf pan? Question mark?
Yes.
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 Yeah, this recipe should make one... sandwich loaf.
Yep.
Yeah.
But it'll be a nice big sandwich loaf.
Yes.
And it'll be really fluffy and delightful.
We have lots of questions.
Oh, great. Then I'll put this in the tripod.
Okay. Is the bread crunchy or soft? I have a family who can't have hard bread.
It is a tiny bit crunchy on the outside and mostly soft in the middle.
There we go. We'll go like this.
Somebody wants us to make noodles, too.
Noodles are easy, but they're a pain in the butt because they take a long time.
Yeah. A Thrive Life video would be cool too.
A Thrive Life video, yeah. Well, that's what we're thinking. I want to make that spaghetti, the bolognese spaghetti, because it looks really good. And the thing about the Thrive Foods, guys, is not only is it shelf stable for 25 years, it's fast.
Yeah.
You cut down on your prep time. All you do is you literally go, I got a scoop of this, I got a scoop of that, I got a scoop of that, put water in, and you're good to go.
This particular recipe that made, how many loaves does this recipe make? This recipe that's on the board up here, that makes two thin loaves, or you can make one large loaf. It depends on if you want like a big bread so you can cut it to make Italian crusty bread, or not garlic bread.
Yeah.
It makes one... sandwich loaf bread, and then two of the baguette size.
Well, and this recipe, guys, too, if you wanted to make some killer breadsticks, ridiculous breadsticks, make same loaf or same amount of dough, but you roll them out however you want, whatever size. Maybe you want like super long ones and you just get them really skinny. Mm-hmm. But then when they're done, take them for a little bath in butter and garlic.
That's what we should do with this batch.
Garlic bread.
Yep.
Or breadsticks.
Breadsticks, yeah.
And they are way better than the ones you could ever get at Olive Garden.
Right.
By far.
Another question.
Dolphin Man is suggesting making our dumplings for a live video.
Ooh.
Oh, we can do that. That's easy.
Dumplings are super simple.
And that's all you, because you make it.
Well, the only problem... Yeah, I do make it. The only problem with dumplings, though, is I never measure anything.
No, you don't. But it's a look and a feel to
it. It's totally like the bread when she was doing the dough. You got to get it to a right consistency, but That does sound pretty good.
I know Jennifer asked, is it regular? Scroll back up real quick.
Sorry.
That's okay. Rapid rise yeast or regular? This is regular dry active yeast. It's not rapid rise.
Is there a brick in the fridge, freezer? I'll go get it.
It's in the deep freeze.
And there's stuff all over.
Jonathan?
Hey, Jonathan's the one that covered our deep freezer with stuff.
Please go get a brick of the yeast from the deep freeze.
We'll show you exactly what we use.
Yeah. I store all of our yeast in the freezer. It lasts
for years.
It lasts for years. Even though the ones that we have are vacuum sealed, it still lasts a ton longer.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Do you still only bake it for 30 minutes if you make it into one loaf?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. You bake it until it's nice and brown, like crusty brown on the top. And like if you make it in a sandwich loaf, I wouldn't put the egg or the sesame on it.
No.
At least we never do because it's for the kids.
Oh, you know what we got to show them, Mama? Hmm. Your hamburger bun recipe.
Oh, we will.
The hamburger buns, she just found a new recipe, and it was ridiculous.
Yeah.
I mean, I personally, I don't like, I mean, I don't know about you guys, but where the heck are the good delis anymore?
They're gone.
You know?
There's Cervati's. They still make good rolls, but...
But the thing is this, you go to your grocery store, and let's say you want to have hamburgers, okay?
Right.
And when we make hamburgers, I don't make these teeny weeny little things that look like a... You know, a 50 cent piece.
No.
We spread them out and get them a little wider. And,
right.
and when you do that, you can't find buns that will fit. And so, Mama made these buns, and they were sesame topped, and they were perfect size.
The only thing is they're square. I have to figure out how to make them round.
We need a little ring, some kind of ring that's the right size.
Beautiful. Thank you, honey.
All right.
This is what we get.
Yep.
It's the Red Star Dry Active Yeast. And we get it from GFS, Gordon Food Service.
Yeah, it's restaurant supply.
It's about $4. It's less than $4.50. Sorry, am I bothering you, honey?
Yeah, just a little bit.
She hates it when I mess with the chair. Do you wonder why? Because, yeah.
But how I don't even know how you would guess, but how many do you think you get out of this? How many batches?
One of these will last us about 3 to 4 months.
And we make a lot of bread.
Yeah, we make a lot of bread. So this would last somebody who doesn't make a lot of bread a year.
Probably a year.
But this is a 2-pound brick of vacuum sealed dry active yeast. Or sorry, active dry yeast. And
for the preppers out there, because I've seen some of you coming through the chat here, this is the way to go.
Oh, yeah.
Vacuum sealed.
Vacuum sealed.
Yep.
Yep.
So even if you didn't have refrigeration, that's still going to last you a year.
Mm-hmm. It'll last longer than that.
Yep. And in that time, you can learn how to make your own yeast. Well, actually, you harvest yeast, really.
You would be making sourdough at that point.
Well, there's different kinds of yeast for different kinds of things.
Well, yes, but if you're making bread, you would leave your sugar and your water and your flour on the counter.
You can. Questions, Mama.
Have you ever put Parmesan cheese in your dough?
That sounds really good.
That sounds delightful. Yeah.
That sounds real good.
Yeah.
And maybe some, I don't know, what else would I put in there? I would put in there...
Some garlic.
Parsley.
Some rosemary.
Ooh.
Basil. You could add whatever you want, but I would add it to the dough as you're adding the water to it.
Well, and one of the things that we really like to do, guys, like when you have like a meal that you want to have something extra, like... You know that everybody's going to be hungry if they didn't have just something else. We'll take one of these things of bread out, and we'll pour some nice olive oil into like a little dish, and then we'll put some salt, some pepper in there, maybe some basil, and we use it as a dipping oil. And boy, oh boy, one loaf of bread goes away right fast. What?
There was somebody that was asking if they could pre-order soap.
I'm assuming that
was for the soap.
Yes.
It's for the peppermint because we're out.
Go ahead. We need to put some because we have 60 bars curing of the peppermint.
We need to go ahead
and add it to the website.
Okay. I can do that before the day's up, guys, so I'll add more of that of the stuff that we've already made.
Yep. Somebody's from Australia here?
Cool.
Sweet.
It's 4:44 there.
Yeah, Richard, the option isn't there. We just need to add the inventory to the website, and we'll do that.
I'll do that today.
Yeah. Let me go check, see how much time is left.
Here, let's go see what time's left. Maybe we can tease Jonathan on the way. We'll poke him. Oh, we got to look at the soap on the way. There's the soap. Curing.
Yeah.
How much time, Mama?
17 minutes.
Okay, 17 minutes. You guys got to come up with some more content for us.
Any more questions?
Mm-hmm. Oh my gosh, so it's starting to smell good.
Yeah, I cracked the oven just
a little bit. It's starting to smell good.
It's looking yummy.
Our ladies have been good to us, you see.
Oh my gosh, yes.
We have how many birds?
20.
And we get how many eggs a day?
18,
consistently. 18 eggs. Yep. Yeah. And it's supposed to get down to 32 degrees tonight. So.
Hopefully our fruit trees don't.
This is the most awesome, awesome addition to anybody's homestead ever. This wood burning stove keeps our house, which is like 1,500, 1,600 square feet. This is how we heat. Doesn't cost us a penny because we get, you know, wood from all over the place. And there's Jonathan. He's chilling out again. And he's playing video games. All right. Back in here. What other questions we got? Sell your eggs and soap. What else do you sell from your homestead? Well, we do lip balms. We do hand lotions.
Yep.
We also are dabbling with some medicinal oils that you rub on your feet at night.
Yep.
That really have some amazing, amazing benefits.
Yeah, I know.
So.
Okay.
Questions, Mama.
Catherine says American ovens look huge. Yeah, they are. They're quite big. There was a question. Oh, what was it? Shoot. Oh, so sell your eggs. And so we just don't have an outlet for our eggs just yet. We're considering putting a sign out front saying
here, I'll put this
eggs
up here.
For sale.
We basically have been giving them away to friends.
Right.
Because, you know, I mean, we have them. We want them. They're there. We have dual purpose birds so that they're actually going to be food at some point,
right.
too.
Right.
But I saw Dolphin Man. What did he just ask?
If your oven was off, can you bake on your wood stove?
No. You could in a Dutch
cast iron
mm-hmm. but not inside it.
Right. Mm-hmm. Our wood stove is too small. We probably could, but
it would, but I wonder.
We could on a smaller scale. If we had one of those Dutch ovens that had the lip on the top. We could probably do that, you know, a smaller loaf inside the oven.
Or I'm wondering if you just got the fire to a place where it's just nice and coals, and you put a shallow rack and then bake right on top of it.
Yeah.
I don't know if it would get too smoky.
You'd have to have a top on it.
I don't know. That's a question that's really interesting. So what else is going on, Mama?
I'm not sure.
Are we supposed to be doing anything with those other loaves? We are.
Yeah, but not yet. We can go ahead and do that.
We'll bring them back out, and that way at least they're seeing what we're doing.
All right.
So she's going to bring the dough back out. Let's see. I'll get this camera set up to where you guys can see it okay. There we go. Okay. Where is the bread? It's in the oven. It's in the oven. We're working on it. Okay, now this is the stuff that we just made.
Yep.
Oh, kicking the tripod.
Holy smokes.
Bad Brad. So you can see that it's risen some, but you would really want to let this rise a lot longer.
Another
15 minutes.
10, 15 minutes, yeah.
Mama.
So I've got an egg wash here that is one whole egg and about a teaspoon of water. And I'm just going to use my pastry brush to brush this on the top here. The top and the sides.
There we go. She never lets me do this.
That's not true.
Mm-mm. She never lets me do this. See, we have a pretty good arrangement, to be honest.
He makes dinner, I make bread.
And well, the thing is that in all honesty, I cook probably 80% of the time.
90.
Maybe 90.
Mm-hmm.
But the nice thing for me is I don't have to clean up the mess. That's the trade-off.
That's my job.
That's a trade-off.
And he makes a humongous mess.
I am a messy cook. There's no doubt. If there is a pan that I can use, I will have found it.
And he will dirty it, even though he doesn't use it to cook dinner.
Well, and sometimes I'll start with one dish and go, well, this is the wrong one for this.
Yeah, I know.
So I am definitely the messy cook.
We could probably start making those into...
Let's take a look. Oh, yeah. No, it's good to go.
Breadsticks.
Yeah.
All
right. I'm going to hold this up, but check this out, guys. That's the other one right there.
Would this be the right dough to use to make cinnamon swirl bread?
No,
you need a sweeter dough.
You need a sweeter dough.
And actually, if you look up our Amish sweet bread, our Amish sweet white, mm-hmm. we have a video up for that, and that's the bread you would use for the dough.
Now I'm taking this really sharp knife, and I'm just slicing across the top, just so that if the bread does expand, it doesn't...
break.
It doesn't
cracks.
Break and kind of blow out one side. I can't stand it when dough does that. I got too many loaves and too many slices.
Yeah, it looks good. It looks great.
Okay.
So then this we're going to probably make into breadsticks.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to stick this in the kitchen.
Here, I can do that.
Okay. Well, I need the plastic thing with the flour on top of it.
Got it.
What kind of butter do we buy?
Regular butter. Store-bought, store-name butter. There's where there is two ingredients. It's cream and salt. I don't buy margarine. And if we had a larger or more cows, we could make, we could make our own butter. But we don't have enough milk and cream to make our own.
You know, that is one of those things. Butter is so dang expensive to make. We actually end up, even though we can make our own butter, we buy it.
Yeah.
We buy it because it's just so cost prohibitive, unless you have a really big cow.
Yeah, if we had a Jersey or, well, I don't
want to over Hannah.
She's in her apron as well. Hi, she's in her apron.
And she said she loves your apron.
Claire's thank in. You. Yeah. This was made for me by Katie over at the Goin' Batty channel, and she made all the girls an apron, and I absolutely love it.
And she's a young lady. She's 13.
13, yep.
And so she sews like a beast.
She does. I think she just put out a video today of
so
her
what?
Sewing.
I think that's what it was called.
Yeah, so what?
So
exactly.
What?
Yep, that's funny. So we're going to make this into breadsticks. Jonathan, I need another cookie sheet.
I'll get a cooking sheet.
Or probably two.
I'll be right back.
So we're going to knock this out, but we're not going to need this. We want this to be nice and fluffy. It's easier to work with if you don't knead it first. When you need, the more you knead it, K-N-E-E-A-D, then the harder it is to work with.
Lord.
What?
Nothing. We've just had like six rolls.
Fabulous. That's my favorite.
I know.
Not
me
really.
Too. It gives me an anxiety.
And we only have 9 minutes left till the bread's done.
Woohoo! Snack time. All right. We're going to go ahead and line these with some parchment. Parchment.
Oh, here it is. I got it.
Hi, Sarah.
Sarah who?
Just Sarah.
Just say Sarah?
Just Sarah.
Sarah Anna.
Cool.
Yeah, I think the next video we'll do that Thrive Life spaghetti sauce.
All right, sounds good.
Bolognese.
All right.
Here, I'll get you the camera so we can have some close-ups.
Huh? All right, we're going to knead this out like we did the other dough. I'm still getting used to this. Oh.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Well, it slips on this table.
Yeah, this I don't usually use this when I'm rolling out dough. I usually use the counter.
My husband will be so happy to come home and smell Chris's bread in the oven.
Oh,
I
got to
tell you what, guys, it smells delightful right now. There is nothing like fresh baked bread.
Yeah.
To make you feel like home.
Mm-hmm.
The rolling pin. What is that kind? It's a specific thing.
It's a French rolling pin. And I think they use it more for pastries, but I don't. I'm not very good at that.
You see?
Yeah, it's tapered on the ends.
Yep. And she's still new at it.
I'm still very new at it. Okay. Now, how do we want to do this?
Because we're going to make this into breadsticks.
We're going to make this. Should we just cut
them? Just cut them. Leave it.
Okay.
Let's try it.
I'm going to get the pizza cutter.
We are experimenting right now.
Yep.
We've never done this before. So we're going to come over here and heckle Claire. Hi, Claire.
Hi.
She's doing a good job slaying the trolls.
It's been like six.
Really?
Yeah.
All slaying at your mighty hand.
Yeah.
How many batches are you making?
Oh, I've made three total, but
this is just one batch.
This is one batch. This is one recipe.
Right. So this is an excellent way if you want to just cut stuff up small.
This is so easy. This is a great way to cut noodles, and I'm just going to slice it just like this.
Because they're going to rise up and get poofy.
Yep.
Those are some big honking.
We can twist them. Oh.
You want to twist them?
We can twist them.
Ooh.
We'll try it with one.
I could make a bow tie. Now, is there such a thing as letting it rise too long?
Yes, because the yeast will die.
We need to keep our yeast active and healthy.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I'm going to take this one, and I'm going to just...
Give it a twist?
Give it a twist.
This is happening right now.
I've never done this before.
Wait, what are you making?
This is going to be breadsticks.
Jonathan, come here.
Maybe you should twist them, hanging them, like holding them upright.
Can you get this out of here?
Twist them around bacon.
Ooh,
oh, yeah.
Bacon twisted. Look at yummy. There's Jonathan. He's helping out. Say hi.
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 There.
He's studying to be a firefighter.
Long. Should we do them shorter?
You could cut them in halvesies.
Let's cut them in halvesies.
We're going to need more cookie sheets.
Yeah, we will.
I can go get them.
But if we do them this way, here.
What? Watch. You could weave it together into like a bread platter.
Woohoo! Yeah, that'd be cool.
A bread platter. I'll go get some more cookie sheets.
Look at that! That looks so cute.
And I think we're actually almost done with the
loaves. It looks cute. It looks so cute. They are. They're so cute. See, look at that. And see how that is? I amuse myself.
You amuse yourself?
I amuse myself.
Good Lord.
You be quiet, young lady.
I'm not doing anything.
You be quiet, young lady.
I'm not doing anything.
Yeah, having them shorter like this is way better than...
Well, I'll get a close-up here, too. But we're only 4 minutes and a half till the bread's ready.
Do we have soft butter?
Ooh, yes, we do.
Nope.
Jonathan, please make sure we have soft butter. Because you cannot have warm bread without soft butter.
Soft butter. Oh. Okay. These don't look exactly Martha Stewart-ish, but they're cool.
I'm not Martha Stewart.
Holy bread, Batman.
Holy bread.
Batman.
Yeah.
Nice. All right. See? Okay, you just twist them. Alternate.
We'll try a different way. See if you can, since we're experimenting right now. Here, I'll make one. I'm going to make one.
You're good at this.
I am not. But we'll give it a try.
How about a knot? Oh, a knot. Look at that.
That's naughty.
Oh, brother.
Yep, that's not going to work. It's not going to work like I thought.
See? Garlic knots, guys. Look at that. Well, not the short, not these long ones. They have to be short.
Yeah, you're right. That doesn't look so good. I give. That was not a great idea.
Garlic knot. Look at.
Garlic knots.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
See? Look. Just tie it in a knot.
Tie it in a bow. Do your ears hang low? Do they?
Wobble to and fro?
Something like that. Tie them in a knot. You can tie them in a bow. Do your ears hang. This one looks horrible.
That's because it's too long. You had it
it's
too
a,
long.
It's a dough. See, ball.
This is why I don't let him make bread.
I'll stick to the cameras.
Yeah,
and,
you do that.
And the other stuff. Mine looks like, Freddy Krueger made it.
Oh, nice. You look at those toys.
Martha ain't got nothing on you, Crystal.
Oh, right. Whatever.
That is true. She has not been to federal prison.
That is true. I have never been to federal prison, nor will I ever go to federal prison.
The door wall.
Yeah. It'll work, Brad. All
right.
You could stuff them and make mini calzones. I love that idea, Lone Star Living.
Fantastic idea.
Heck yeah. Alrighty.
I think we're having spaghetti tonight.
I think we are. We're definitely having spaghetti. We might go live here in a little bit when I'm making the sauce.
That's too funny. These little knots are so cute.
Yeah.
Don't laugh. Martha is the richest woman in the world, prison and all.
That's funny. That's funny.
10% of her income and we'll be good.
Oh my gosh, if we ever earn 10% of her income.
If we earn like 5%.
I know.
We'd still be
a millionaire.
Right. See, you guys just saw history being made right here.
They still don't.
You know what? I don't care. Here.
You know what? No, all you got to do, Mama.
I like them. No.
All you got to do is make up some name that nobody's thought of, and then you'll be considered a food genius because you came up with the blah blah blah.
I don't want to be a food genius.
These are knots of love. See, they're knots of love, and now all of a sudden, going from hey, we just threw this dough together because we have it to being genius. It's like when you ask a kid, you know, who's in high school and they're like a, you know, senior, hey, what are you going to do? What are you going to go study?
Going to make knots of love.
No, but the kid that goes, well, I don't really know, they kind of sound goofy. But if the kid says, I'm keeping my options open, they go from silly to genius.
Whatever.
Keeping my options open.
Calm down, young lady. It's really okay. These guys have no life, and so they have to, you know, bother us. Jonathan, we need another cookie sheet.
I made a brioche. Cool.
What's brioche? Is that it goes on the crust?
No, it's like axle grease. You put it into your tractor where the who's its meets the what's its.
Right. Hey, Jonathan, check that bread, please.
Oh no, I'll do it.
Okay.
How many seconds?
20.
Oh, come on, Mama. We got to get in here.
Look, aren't those cute?
Oh, there's my room out there. That's where they keep me.
Yeah, that's his hole.
Man cave. Six. Here we go. It's happening real time, guys. Let's see. Are we ready?
Oh, baby, my gracious.
Look at that. Oh, holy wow.
Yummy. Here, all right, let's put these in.
Yep, these guys are going in. Reset. Yep. I am hungry.
Yeah. Timer.
But take a look at that, guys. Now, one neat thing about bread that if you're doing the method where you put the water in there and you bring it out, it'll crackle, and it's called singing.
It sings.
I don't know if we can. I can't hear it.
I don't hear it.
But let's bring this into the other room and feast.
Let me get a cutting board.
Okay. Oh my gracious. I do wish you had smell-o-vision, guys.
Well, if they were making it, then they would be smelling it. Right?
Yep.
I know this bread's going to be cranking hot.
Yep.
Ouch. Yes, it is. Touched my finger.
I'll bring the butter.
Jonathan, you grab the butter.
You grab the butter, Jonathan. Yay. Jonathan's got the butter. Yeah. Bet Brad eats an entire loaf. Depends on how I'm feeling. But look at that. Nice. Hear it? Go ahead.
Nice.
To give you an idea of the crust.
Yep.
It's not super crunchy, but it's definitely not soft.
No, go get nice butter.
Nice butter.
That's all melted, gross-looking butter. All right, so this is hot, but I'm going to cut it just
a little bit.
Ouch, it's really hot.
Take a look at that. I want the end.
Ouch.
It's
that then. You got a hot pad right there.
Yeah, I know. Well, it tore.
Look at that. Nice.
Yeah. That looks really good.
Here, I'm willing to burn myself.
Yeah, I'm not.
I'm willing to burn myself. Going in. Oh my gosh, the bottom.
It's really crunchy.
That is good. Oh my gracious.
Any questions, Claire?
Any questions?
No. Everybody's just saying how good it looks.
Well, guys.
I wish you were here. Because all this bread, man, there's a lot.
Yeah. And you guys see, it's not hard. We just did this right before your very eyes. Well, not we. She did.
Well, yeah, but it's, you know, the ingredients are, they're so minimal. And making bread is really, really easy if you just follow the ingredient and follow the instructions.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, just make sure you don't use too hot of water.
Another one? No, it's just the recipes. It was in the description, but it's not anymore.
I'll hold up the recipe again. I put it in the description. I don't know why it's not showing up. All right. Here it is. Oops. Reflections on the screen there. 2.5 cups of water. 4 teaspoons of sugar. 1 tablespoon of dry active yeast. Flour. 4 teaspoons of sea salt. Bake at 375 for 30 minutes. For the process, you're going to have to rewatch the video.
Yep.
So.
Because I'm not doing it again.
Nope. Not today.
No.
And there you have it, guys. Easy to make French bread.
We make our own butter.
We do not make our own butter. We know how, but we don't.
Yeah. We are using all bread flour at the moment. You can use all-purpose flour.
There's your piece, Mama.
Thank you. But I like the consistency. And the crumb that bread flour makes with the bread. I thought you wanted the end.
You did. You said you wanted. So I just cut off the other end.
Did you see this? He cut off the ends.
What? He's so you funny. Said you wanted one.
No, it was fine. It was fine. Here, bread or butter.
Well, we should say goodbye first.
Eat in front of them.
Here's the thing, guys. We're gonna be trying to do this every Friday, where we're gonna bring you guys some kind of skill, like making the soap that we did last week, or bread. I think we're gonna do some spaghetti sauce coming up soon, the bolognese, and so make your suggestions. Put some suggestions in the comments of stuff you'd like to see done, because we actually do a lot of different odd things. Everything from making, you know, fresh cheeses to, mm-hmm. You know, you could show them how to make goat's cheese.
We could, yeah, goat cheese is
super simple.
Yeah, it really is.
So make some suggestions, and we're going to try to make this a normal thing on Friday.
Yep.
And we'll figure out how to work this all out better in advance. But
hey, you know, we created some really cool stuff just on the fly.
That's true. And without any flies. There were no flies in the house.
No flies today. Yay!
So also, guys, if you're interested in getting some of that goat's milk soap that we mm-hmm. That we make, you can buy it at Big Family Homestead Store.
Yep.
And so with that, see you later.
Have a great day, everybody.
Bye. I'm going to shut this
make
up.
Make some bread.
Go make some bread. Jeez, oh, Pete, you lazy people.
Oh, nice.
No, they're not.
I know.
Are you sure you want to stop?
Yes.
Streaming? Yes.